of the glory of God. So God, he will reframe what you're looking at. There was a man in the Bible called Paul. Some of y'all might have read him before. The Bible said, Gigi, that one day he was preaching in Jerusalem. And after he had finished preaching, that the Roman government, they came and they laid hands on Paul. His hand was in chains. He had the chains to go around his waist. He had fetters on his feet. Somebody might have looked at Paul and said, Paul is a prisoner of the Roman government.
All right.
But somebody else can take a look at Paul and say that Paul is a prisoner of the Lord. And it's a good thing to be a prisoner of the Lord. It's a good thing to be shackled up, shackled by the Lord. Because when we are chained up to the Lord, those things that we want to say, we won't be able to say. When we're chained to the Lord, those places that we want to go, those chains will keep us from going. When we're shackled up to the Lord, those things that we're desiring to do in that flesh, those chains will hold us back. So here we are in the book of Matthew, that there was a man called Jesus. Somebody called him the Messiah. Someone called him the bread of life. Someone called him Alpha and Omega. Someone called him the teacher. Somebody called him the bright and the morning star. Somebody called him the King of Kings. Somebody called him the Lord of Lords. It don't matter what you call them, but just call them. And I discovered that if you just call them sometime, that he will come see about you. So here we are. It's this man called Jesus. And it was Jesus who introduced the theory, what is a family? How is it you say that you love me? How is it that you say that I am your family, but yet you hurt me? How is it you say that I'm your family, but when I needed you, it was nowhere to be found? And what I've come to discover, Antioch, that there's no greater hurt than a hurt from your own family member.
Amen.
And hurt from someone sitting next to you.
Amen.
Claiming to be a lover of the Lord. There's no greater hurt, Reverend. It was David. Y'all remember King David? It was King David who said, I can endure, I can handle when my enemy come to do me harm. David said, Keith, that I can handle that. Because I understand that the enemy don't like me anyway. I can understand that my enemy hates me anyway. You need to understand there's haters everywhere, Reverend. There's even some haters in the church. There's some haters even in your family. There's haters on your job. This is why we got to be careful when we call people friends. Because what I've come to discover, and what I've always said, that everybody by your side is not on your side. Amen. And some of us, we had to learn the hard way. Just because you got 5,000 friends on Facebook, it don't mean they're your friends. And while we're on Facebook, start telling all your business. There's some things I just don't need to know.
Hallelujah.
I don't need to know what you ate last night. I don't need to know that your feet need to be done. There's some things that should be kept in your home. So here we are, that David says that I can handle those. But the hurt that comes within your family, sometimes those scars never heal. You got some people here right today that the scar has healed up on the outside, but the room is still open on the inside. This is why, Anna, we need to be patient with those who we fellowship with. Because you don't know what they're going through.
Amen.
And not only that, you don't know what they've been through. We have to learn to be patient with one another. The Bible says we are to love thy neighbor. So here we are in Matthew. It was Jesus said that who is my family? Jesus, he was preaching in one of the temples. And based upon this text, it appears that the church was full. And let me just pause and say, just because the church you attend may be full does not mean that Jesus is in it.
Amen.
Because we're living in days now that it's not so much about the souls, but it's how big I can build that church. The Bible teaches us that we are to love the sinners, but to hate the sin. You see, everything cannot go on in the house of the Lord.
Amen.
The Bible tells us, come out from among them.
Amen.